80 to 90 dogs a day. That is a mix of grooming, which are pick-up and drop-off. We have daycares that come and go, and our drop-off times are quite short. So when dogs are coming in and pulling out, it's more like a quick loading and unloading. And then there's things that we can do. We've never had to do it in Lafayette, but that we can do just operationally to assist with the pick-up and drop-off time in speeding up check-in at our peak hours, but I really consider that more of a business operation issue, probably internally to...
Across the street from a row of homes. I own one of those homes. The plans are incomplete on a number of levels. There is a second level, which is not shown on the plans. There is a second level. I haven't been inside, but I can see on the plans, they have not demolished the stairs to the second level. The plans are incomplete. The demolition plans are incomplete in that the tiled floor is not completely demolished, at least not on the dump.
I'd like to take my dogs to a situation where they're going to be comfortable, well taken care of, and if I'm away for any length of time, there's somebody there 24 hours a day. This lady has done a great job. She joined a chamber of commerce.
Directly next to houses that would be specifically forbidden from running a similar facility because of the known propensity to generate noise, odor, and traffic. And this is, again, it's been discussed before, in a zoning district that's explicitly designated to house compatible uses that transition from larger commercial and industrial uses to residential. And it's, again, it's been allowed without any form of design review or traffic study or impact directly next to a school, knowing now that the plans are incomplete.
She is an incredibly responsible business owner. And when you have a wine shop and you have a Jack in the Box literally right next door to your facility, I can guarantee you that she would not do anything to compromise the neighborhood, compromise the business owners, and she's incredibly responsive.
That time, working residents return their homes, the warehouses are closed, to a silence of the night and the weekend. However, now comes a noise-producing business with up to 200 dogs that will permanently and add muffled sounds all night, as well as on their busiest days on weekends. This is a huge, I want to underline that, that's a huge change in the view of having a quiet neighborhood to live in.
The application is incomplete for several reasons. For one, the site plans are vague and misleading and do not address the improvements needed to change the usage of this building from a storage or industrial facility to an animal boarding and daycare business for at least 200 or up to 200 dogs. There are no specifications for the materials needed to make this space safe and habitable for 200 dogs or any dogs. There are no specifications. Specific requirements have been ignored. The city of San Rafael requires the plans to state actual floor area. Missing from the Tail Haven plan.
It was put forward in there. So, and you know, if you ever have a dog that gets clipped or you even get your own hair cut, it's never usually the right way that you want it. So someone's going to be able to write a Yelp complaint about that, and that's fine. Everybody's going to have their opinion to that. I don't think that that is an indication of a poorly run facility. The boarding facility that I live next to in San Rafael, as the crow flies, is probably less than a 16th of a mile away, you know. There is residential behind it, behind the hill. They have outdoor facilities as well. As I mentioned, I've never heard a complaint about them. But if you read their Yelp, there are people that will complain about the facility. So they choose to go somewhere else. And I think that's the ability that we have here, is if we don't like it, if we don't like the restrictions that they put on in their business, then you don't have to go there. If they choose, have you choose to sign?
I too have read the Yelp reviews, and they are about grooming. There's not one in there about noise, about odors, about anything that that have been raised in the appeal. So the proven track record convinces me. And the second point is the third review we've had. This has been through two levels of hearings and review by people that I trust, and it's been upheld all the way through. So I think the conditional use permit was properly granted, and therefore I would join my colleagues in denying the appeal. And in conclusion, I would then move that we adopt the resolution denying the appeal.